Well, there has been a lot of confusion about whether we are seeing murder hornets here in Maryland. And joining us with some answers is the bug guy, Dr. Michael Raupp from the University of Maryland College Park. Hey, it's great to see you.
Morning, Jen. Great to see you, too. How are you doing today?
I am doing great. And you told me you must be getting, what, 10 emails about this a day at least?
Yep, this is how I start my morning every day, is opening up the email. And by golly, there's a picture of maybe a murder hornet in there, but really not. Most of the pictures, in fact, all of the dozens of pictures I've received are actually one we call the European hornet.
And they're closely related, but really not at all the same thing.
Not at all the same thing. And Jen, what I'd like to do is show our viewers today maybe how you can tell these two guys or two gals apart, actually. Now, this is the Asian giant hornet. This insect is going to be almost 2 inches long. The other one is the European hornet. These are queens that people are seeing in their homes, in the fireplace, in the basement, in the attic right now. And these are only going to be about an inch and a half. So the relative size proportions here are accurate. Now, the way you're really going to tell them apart is to look right here on the abdomen. Mm-hmm. Notice we have several bands, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 or 7 bands. These bands are uniform. The margins are even. Now, if we look at the European hornet, we can see 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 bands. And look at these funny little peduncles or little dots mm-hmm. at the base right here. So the posterior margin on your European hornet is going to have these funny little black dots, whereas your Asian giant hornet, hey, those margins are going to be uniform. These are going to be bigger. They're going to have a yellow head. These gals are a little bit smaller.
And the nice thing is, you told me, unless one were to hop a ride in the Port of Baltimore, we're really not expected to get these for years to come because they're out in the Northwest right now. And
yeah,
they're just not going to fly
these
here.
These gals are 3,000 miles away
yeah.
right now. There's no indication that they're anywhere close. It would simply take by natural spread years to decades before they hit the East Coast. So let's just relax, get outside, and enjoy a beautiful weekend, as Taylor said, with a COVID-free walk in the park or something like that.
But what we are starting to see is some cicada activity, right?
Absolutely. There's the gang right there. This one is the vanguard of what we call Brood 10. Every cicada brood, we have guys that arise just a little bit off schedule, the vanguard. These are called stragglers. And we're getting many reports right now in the Baltimore, Washington region of these guys showing up. So this is really cool. But unfortunately, these guys have kind of a foolish gene. They're not going to contribute to the gene pool next year when the big brood emerges. And by then, we will literally have billions of cicadas per square mile. So next year is the main event. Don't worry about these. If you see them, there's a wonderful app, citizen science app. It's called Cicada Safari. It's a free download. If you see these guys, go to Cicada Safari, report these, because we're still trying to figure out exactly when and where these different broods of cicadas are.
Well, and they're important markers of what's to come. And so just give people a quick idea, if they don't remember, the sound that we're expected to hear next year when those 17-year cicadas come out.
Okay, it's going to be the sound of a jet aircraft going by or my neighbor's really noisy lawnmower, which I had to close the window for. They're going to hit about 100 decibels when the big boy band is up in the treetop. So this is going to be pretty spectacular. A wonderful opportunity to see all of nature's wonders, like having a Nat Geo special in your backyard.
I love
it. This is going to be a pretty cool event.
Dr. Raupp, thank you so much. You make learning about bugs fun, which is so awesome.
Well, they should be. They're pretty cool. Thanks so much, Jen. Have a great day.
You're welcome. We'll check back in with you later in the summer.